I've come to the Goyt Valley, which is my test facility and somewhere that I often do my car reviews. But I've come here because, number one, it is very, very pretty and a beautiful place to be on a sunny day like this. But number two is because it's a valley and therefore there's a massive hill going down into it. And basically, I'm going to go down this hill in this Fiat 500e and see how much energy can I recuperate. So the Goyt Valley, from this point here at the top, is 1 mile down to the bottom, and it will descend during that time 150 metres, which is like descending almost the entire height of the Beetham Tower in Manchester, which was the largest skyscraper in Manchester. So it's quite a significant drop. Basically, the weight of this car going down that hill is going to regenerate energy into the battery, and I really want to know how much it will do that. So let's go and see what we can gain. So this car has got a 42 kilowatt hour battery. We're on 53% now, so if we could gain like say 1% of energy as we go down this hill, then we've gained 0.42 kilowatt hours of energy, which is actually a huge amount of energy. If you think about how much it would take to get a big heavy metal box going like this. So with these two screens on here, I can see whether the energy is going back into the battery or whether the battery is using expending energy. And I don't want to see any red, I just want it to be all blue. Blue is good, blue is regeneration, and red is expending energy. Now I'm using a mode called SHERPA mode, and that's basically like, Fiat say that it's like having a mountain SHERPA, which would help you go up Mount Everest or whatever, keeping an eye on everything for you. So he's reduced the energy consumption of the car. He's done that by turning off the climate controls completely, so you don't have any heating or air conditioning. And also he's limited the car to 50 miles an hour, but that's not really going to be an issue here. It adds in a massive amount of regenerative braking when you let go of the accelerator pedal. It's this one pedal driving thing where you can basically drive the car only using the accelerator pedal, and you never ever have to touch the brake pedal unless it's an emergency, because regenerative braking will do it all for you. Regenerative braking, that essentially is the electric motor spinning in reverse and regaining energy into the battery, which is really quite an amazing thing, and you're basically getting free fuel as you go down the hill. Now, of course, at some point, you probably have to go back up the hill. What goes down must then come up again. There is one issue with SHERPA mode, and I find that the car tends to steam up a bit because obviously you've got no climate controls, you've got no air conditioning or heating, removing the steam and from your breath and so on. So we're coming to the steepest part now, and this valley, as I say, it descends 150 metres in just 1 mile. So we're going now, and I can see that I've got a significant amount of regeneration. On this screen here, I'm gaining 12 kilowatts of energy.
This is enough energy at this given moment to power 120 mid-size laptops or 80 fridges.
The other thing to consider as you're going down a big hill in one of these cars is that the car isn't using its brakes at all. So the brake pads and discs are not getting any use pretty much at any time. So I think I could do an absolute ton of miles in a car like this without ever replacing the brake pads. We're currently still on 53% as we make our way down this steep hill. I wouldn't bother with the normal mode, by the way. That's what I'd call a bro, do you even electric car mode, because that mode, you have no regenerative braking on the throttle whatsoever, so you have to basically use the brake pedal to get the energy back. And one pedal driving is, oh, there we go. One pedal driving is where it's at. We've just made it to 54%. So at least we've gained 1% on this journey, which is, you know, it's a huge amount of energy actually. Not 0.42 kilowatt hours of energy it's enough to run your average 55 inch TV for 5.5 hours. And I've just gained that energy just in the last like two minute driving down this hill, descending the valley like that. So I'm running out of a hill now, so we're coming down to the bottom. Yeah, and the ground's leveling out now, so I'm gonna have to end the mission here, but I'm just gonna pull in here and we can see what we've achieved. So honestly, I probably would have liked to see more than 1% increase, but it's not nothing over that 150 metre drop. I think that the key thing here is with electric cars, what I find is that you just end up driving them differently, because they do have this incredible torque available to you, especially from low speed. So if you're doing 0 to 30 miles an hour, the performance is like, it's as good as any performance petrol car. And this is just a little Fiat 500. But what I find is that you don't really bother with that because you're always thinking about conserving energy and driving efficiently and being careful and stuff. So it will get you a long distance. You know, this car's got a decent range on it, but in order to make the most of it, especially if you're going on a long journey, you'll want to try and regenerate as much energy as you can and just drive in a more careful manner. And the other thing with electric cars is that they are much better at lower speed, so they're excellent around town. You can do loads of miles around town, but once you're doing like motorway speeds, the efficiency is reduced quite a lot. So you'll find that you prefer to take the more scenic route and take like a sort of 50 miles an hour route, conserve energy that way. So it's just like a slightly different, it's like a little lifestyle change really. If you enjoyed the video or you learned anything or whatever, then please do give it a like. And massive thanks to Onto for sending me the car. If you would like a Fiat 500e, then do check out their website and you can get the car on a subscription. Yeah, thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.